So we'll continue with the routing. So we discussed distance vector routing. You can hear me as well as see the slides. Yes, no. Slide or no? Okay. So link state routing. So link state routing. So yesterday we saw about distance vector routing, where this each router will periodically exchange information about its knowledge about the network, so with its neighbors. Now in link state routing, it will be exchanging this information with the entire internet. So it will send this information to every other node in the network. So that means it has to have something which is called as a idea about what is this network, about this the entire network. So you have something which is called as a link state database. So what is link state database and all such things we'll discuss subsequently, but this is a basic idea. So each router will send information about its neighbors to every other router on the network. So, and this is directly coming from this discussion. This directly comes from this discussion we had earlier. That is the least cost path, the tree, the shortest path. We discussed about how each node will be considered as a root of a tree, and then you will just make the shortest path to every other node. So each network will try to build such a path to every other node, and for this you usually follow something which is called as Dijkstra's algorithm. Dijkstra's algorithm nammala idinathu ubayikunnana ee robot path planning adu volta ayinakku ubayikunna shortest path algorithm anad. So that algorithm is used to compute the shortest path. Each router will compute the shortest path. Now that each of these edges are called as a links, so the nodes which are not reachable, or nodes which to which the links have failed, that will be given an infinite cost. That will be the idea. So each router will have something which is called as a link state database. That is what is the state of the link and what is this, the cost involved. And to compute this link, you follow the Dijkstra's algorithm. Dijkstra's D-I-J-K-S-T-R-A, Dijkstra, that is Dijkstra. So that is, I'll show you the picture of that guy, the person who is behind this algorithm. So this is the Dijkstra. I think he is from Netherlands. So the names sound like that. So this is the basic idea. So it will have the knowledge of the entire network. That is what you call as the link state database, and that is what we saw in the least cost tree earlier. Now so this will share this thing, and each node will again try to build a, using Dijkstra's algorithm, will run on each node and it will build a routing table. That is what it will compute is its cost to reach any other node in the network. So this particular algorithm, which is called as a open shortest path first, it's a using link state routing. So you remember that we are discussing intra domain routing algorithms within the domain. We have not come to this inter domain routing algorithm or inter autonomous system routing algorithms. So intra domain routing algorithm is open shortest path first, and examples a routing information protocol, these two. So so with this idea, we say this is a link state database. So collection of states for each of these links, I mentioned this links which are not reachable, this will be assigned infinity. So A to B, that is 2. A cannot be directly reached to so it is given as infinity. So you say it cannot directly reach C, but it can reach it through B. So in that case, it is given as infinity. Again, D, the cost involved is 3. Again, other nodes E, F, G, it cannot directly, A cannot directly reach, right? So that is, if you follow in this way also, same, A to any other node, right? So this is what each node will have, a link state database. That's a concept. So this will change. This is a dynamic thing. Links can fail, links can become active at any time. So this is a ongoing process. The network changes, the network topology will change dynamically. Network topology may change dynamically. Some new routers may come up, some new routers may go down, all those things. And if the cost might change from dynamically, because some routes might get congestion. So that also, this is all adaptive. It has to adapt, because adaptation comes by through feedbacks received from neighbors. So at the beginning, so each router or at each router will periodically exchange something which is called as a link state packet. So it will contain, you can see, it's sort of a greeting message. It will send it to its neighbors, asking it what is your name and as well as what is the cost involved. That is what you call as link state packet. So it sends a link state packet, and then once it gets this states of the link, it will send this information to every other node by a process which is called as flooding. Flooding is basically multicasting. Multicasting means it will be sent to broadcasting. It will be sent to all other nodes other than the source node. That is what is flooding. So flooding is not a very good strategy, but it will create unnecessary traffic. But this is required for the routing algorithm to work. So anyway, duplicates will be compared. Duplicates will be compared at each node. Each of these link state packets will have sequence numbers of some sort, so that it could be identified at each node. The duplicates could be identified and discarded. Such measures are there. So all this runs as a loop. It runs in a loop within each router, and then once the link state packets have been received, it is compared to check if it is a duplicate. The sequence numbers will be checked, and then that means you could receive the link state packet from more than one node, isn't it? Right, the same link state packet. So that can be avoided by a comparison and eliminating the duplicate packets. Now once this is done, you have an update of the current state of the links, then you will find a shortest path tree to each of these nodes. So that is done using Dijkstra's algorithm. So Dijkstra's algorithm helps you to compute the shortest path tree, and then you form a routing table based on that shortest path tree, right? Right, this is clear. That is, send greeting packets, get information about the links and their cost, and then send this, disseminate this information, that is spread this information through the entire network. That is what we do earlier. So it will send information about my neighbors to every other router. That is what is flooding. And then once all of them have got it, you will just try to build up a shortest path tree and make a routing table. Each router will have a routing table. We will see the steps one by one. So these are the link state packet exchange. So each of these, say A is directly connected to its neighbors B and D. So it has sent a greeting message and received a state of the link, the node B address as well as the cost. So then it will similarly B also will exchange information, and it will collect their information with its neighbors. Then once it is done, it will be spreading out throughout the network, so that everyone else will be aware that say A can be reached through, say C will become aware that A can be reached through B, right? Similarly, F will be becoming aware that it can reach A through E, D, or E, B, or B, C, B, three ways. And from this, you will compute the shortest path. Shortest path is computed based on the least cost pattern. ഈ മൂന്ന് ടേബിൾസും റിസീവ് ചെയ്യും. ഓരോ ഇപ്പോൾ എഫിൻ്റെ കേസാണെങ്കിൽ ഈ മൂന്ന് പാർട്സും റിസീവ് ചെയ്യുന്നുണ്ടാവും. സോ ഇറ്റ് വിൽ ദെൻ ബൈ ഫ്ലഡിങ് ഇറ്റ് വിൽ റീച്ച് ഹിയർ. സോ ദെൻ ഇറ്റ് വിൽ ജസ്റ്റ് കമ്പയർ ദ ടേബിൾസ് ആൻഡ് ജസ്റ്റ് മേക്ക് എ സെലക്ഷൻ ഓഫ് ദ ഷോർട്ടസ്റ്റ് പാത്ത്. റൈറ്റ്. സോ ദിസ് ഇസ് ദ ഷോർട്ടസ്റ്റ് പാത്ത് കാൽക്കുലേഷൻ. സേ വിൽ ടേക്ക് ദ റൂട്ട് ഫോർ നോഡ് എ. വിൽ ടേക്ക് എ ആസ് ദ റൂട്ട് ആൻഡ് ദെൻ രണ്ട് ലിസ്റ്റ് നമ്മൾ മെയിൻറ്റെയിൻ. വിൽ മെയിൻറ്റെയിൻ ടു ലിസ്റ്റ്. One is a temporary list, you call it as a tentative list. That means a temp, it's a temporary list. And the other one is a permanent list. So you'll add set A as the root node. For this is computing the shortest path tree for A as the root. So each of these nodes have to do this thing. So then it will second step, it will add A to the permanent list, and then B, C, and D, its immediate neighbors to the temporary list or the tentative list. Then it will check the cost. It will check the cost. So this link has 5, this is 2, this is 3. The least of them is 2. So this C will be added to the permanent list. So C will be added to the permanent list. Least cost one will be added to the permanent list. Now, then C is added and D is added to the, tentative list, temporary list. Now it will check the path again. So it will see that it is 5, 3. So D can be moved to the permanent list. Again, it will check among these, and B will be added to the permanent list, and finally E will be added to the permanent list. Now the temporary list becomes empty. So it has built up a shortest path tree. So each of these nodes will do such a thing, and this will be used to make. So this is the approach. This is the algorithm. So start set root to the local node and then move to the tentative list. Tentative list is theeran vare. So this is the graph was much more easier to understand. So it is just do this steps over and over. Okay. Least cost path is selected in each run. That is the approach. Right. So this is the routing table. So it will say that A to A 0. B 5. Yeah, right. C 2. D 3, E 6, Y 6, that is 2 plus 4, 6, and the intermediate router is, next router is C, so intermediate router is C. So this is how the routing table is built up. Now if any of these links change, any neighbor will get an information that some of these links change, means it will update this, it will update it. Link state packet and just flood it in the network, so everyone else will be aware of that. So this is an ongoing process. This happens at frequent intervals. So that's regarding the link state routing, path vector routing, and BGP. We'll take up next. We'll see the looking glass also. There is something called as a if you are interested, you could see something which is called as a looking glass. So that it's a feature which is available in, so that is, I'll just share this thing. What is it? Press and now entire screen. So that is LG looking glass. You say looking glass. Looking glass. Okay, looking glass Nixi. Yeah. So this is the looking glass. You are seeing this thing? Yes. So this is the looking glass. Other looking glasses are there. So that is other looking glasses, peering DB, all those things. They will give you looking glasses. So you see that okay, so ഇതിനകത്ത് ലുക്കിംഗ് ഗ്ലാസ് വരുന്നില്ലല്ലോ. എൽ ജി ലുക്കിംഗ് ഗ്ലാസ്. സോ പിയറിംഗ് ഡി ബി. സോ ദിസ് ഇസ് ദ ലുക്കിംഗ് ഗ്ലാസ്. സോ ലെറ്റ് മീ സീ ലിക്സി ഡോട്ട് ഇൻ. സോ ദിസ് ഇസ് ദ ലുക്കിംഗ് ഗ്ലാസ് ഫോർ ഇത് ബോർഡർ ഗേറ്റ്വേ പ്രോട്ടോക്കോൾസിന് വേണ്ടിയുള്ള ഒരു ഇതാണ്. സോ പിയറിംഗ് ഡി ബി. It will show the so NICSI is a something which is called as a internet exchange, National Internet Exchange of India, that is NICSI. So it has something which is called as a peering looking glass facility. So we'll see that. We'll so I used to have this thing lg.nixi.in. ഇതിലായിരിക്കണം വരേണ്ടത്. lg.nixi.in. So you can see for yeah. So this is the we'll get only the BGP summary as of now. BGP കാണാമല്ലോ അല്ലേ? അല്ലേ? You can see? Yes, no? Yeah. So you can these are internet exchange എന്ന് പറയുന്ന സാധനം say this is for the different ISPs. So ISPs which have agreements with NICSI, they can join NICSI just like that. So there are some conditions. You can join and then they can terminate their networks there. Appo Reliance and Asianet, they can exchange traffic via NICSI. Source Reliance ആണ്, ഡെസ്റ്റിനേഷൻ ഏഷ്യനെറ്റ് ആണെങ്കിൽ. സോ സെയിം സിറ്റി ട്രാഫിക് ആണെങ്കിൽ ഇപ്പോൾ വളരെ നന്നായിരിക്കും. സോ ഡിഫറെൻറ്റ് ബോംബെ ഒറിജിനേറ്റിംഗ് ട്രാഫിക് ക്യാൻ ബി ടെർമിനേറ്റഡ് ഇൻ ദ ബോംബെ NICSI itself. സോഴ്സ് ആൻഡ് ഡെസ്റ്റിനേഷൻ ബോംബെ തന്നെയാണെങ്കിൽ അങ്ങനെയൊക്കെ ചെയ്യാൻ പറ്റും. സോ ഇറ്റ് വിൽ ഡിക്രീസ് ദ ലേറ്റൻസി. ദാറ്റ് ഇസ് വാട്ട് ദേ ഹാവ് ഡിഫറെൻറ്റ് നോഡ്സ്. ദേ ആർ ഹാവിങ് ടെസ്റ്റ് നോഡ്സ് ഇൻ IPv6 ടെസ്റ്റ് നോഡ് ഇസ് ദെയർ. സോ യു കുഡ് സീ the summary of routes, they say neighboring address, all those things, autonomous system numbers, and advertising. So routes, it is saying different parameters. Okay, so when we get to BGP, border gateway protocol, that is a intra. I just showed it right now because it's all because number of neighbors configured 34 and 30 are up links, right? Basically these are the links which are up. So these are advertising routes to only this many nodes. If we check this node, what is this node? This is this is shown as these are peers. ഇൻ്റർനെറ്റ് എക്സ്ചേഞ്ച് പിയേഴ്സ് ആണ്. ദീസ് ആർ റൈറ്റ്. സോ ദി വോണ്ട് ഗെറ്റ് ദ പാരാമീറ്റേഴ്സ് ഫോർ അതർ തിങ്സ്. ഡിഫറെൻറ്റ് സ്റ്റേറ്റ്സ് ഓഫ് ദിസ് നെറ്റ്വർക്ക്. അപ്പോൾ ഇതിൻ്റെ അകത്ത് ദീസ് ആർ ഓൾ പിയേഴ്സ്, പിയേഴ്സ് ആണ്. സോ so we get quite a lot of information from such sources kada. These are public domain sources. Then we also need to familiarize with one command. So idu nokal lg. Say you will say it as lg.nixie.in. so this will be the link for that lg.nixie.in. you can see a border gateway protocol summary. So what the topic which we take up next, that will be BGP, Border Gateway Protocol. Then the command, regarding the commands for today, you will familiarize with two commands. One is traceroute, that is right. ടെർമിനൽ കാണാമല്ലോ അല്ലേ, പ്രസൻറ്റേഷൻ. ആ ടെർമിനൽ എത്തിയില്ല ഇവിടെ. റൈറ്റ്, യു വിൽ ഫെമിലറൈസ് വിത്ത് ടു കമാൻഡ്സ്. വി സോ റൂട്ട് ആൻഡ് റൂട്ട് കണ്ടായിരുന്നു. ദെൻ വാട്ട് എൽസ്? റൂട്ട്, പിങ്. ദെൻ വി സോ നെറ്റ് സ്റ്റാറ്റ്. Now today's is trace route is in for Unix, and for Linux it is trace rt. Linux system il chalpa illennokke parayum, anganeyane install cheyandi varum.